everybody. Whoever's going to tune in, good day to you today. Today's Wednesday. What a beautiful day outside. I am going to be going outside right after I'm done this, go for a walk, try and get a little bit of the nice weather before the sun's completely gone. So today, new day, new song. And as you can see which guitar I'm playing, it's because the song is played in standard tuning. The band I decided to play the song from today is Def Leppard. And the song I'm going to do is probably one of the most popular songs in their catalog, one of the most. So, it could very well get banned. But I'm doing Pour Some Sugar on Me. So, this is a fun song. Actually, it's a pretty fun song to play. It's really simple. It has some pretty fun little guitar licks and little pieces in there, which is very common for Def Leppard. If you know Def Leppard or are a fan of their music, it's guitar-based rock, and there's a lot of really cool, fun little licks in there that they play. There are two guitar players in the band, and some of the stuff is really, really simple that the second guitar player is playing. But it really adds for some nice layering, so they can play off each other and do some fun stuff. So I'm going to try and do some of the pieces. There are pieces that are two different guitars, and sometimes it's hard for me to get from one to the next. But anyway, we'll see how it goes. I'm going to try it anyway. So before we get into the song, I'll break it down. Yesterday I mentioned about a power chord and how a power chord is really, it's two strings. But that's not 100% true, because you can play a power chord as like a power chord is a portion or of a bar chord. And a complete bar chord would be, depending on where it's barred, would be playing, you can play 3, 4, 5, all the strings. But a power chord is typically two, maybe three strings that are played. Right? So, anyway, I said yesterday two strings. Can also be three strings, sometimes even four strings, because it's based off of the root of the bar, the complete bar chord. Anyway, just thought I'd correct myself there. So, Def Leppard, Pour Some Sugar on Me. I'm going to break it down for you here. It starts off with this little guitar riff, little guitar lick. It's kind of neat. Right? So, cool. Fun. Little lick. Then the verses, a bunch of the verses, there's nothing in there. There's no guitars. He's just singing with bass and drums. And then the guitars kind of come in toward the middle of the verse, and they're just playing this kind of neat little thing. Now, I was talking about a bar chord. Now, for me, when I play bar chords, I like to play bar chords. A lot of people will play, if you're playing 2 frets, most people play based on the number of frets based on number of fingers. So if I'm playing here on the 4th fret, I use my index finger here. The next fret, if I had to play it, would be this finger, then this finger, then this finger. And I don't do that. If you translate that to a bar chord, if you're going up 2 frets, this would be your bar chord, these two fingers, typically, right? For me, I don't know why, but I just like using my baby finger there, and I leave these two free. Right or wrong, I don't know what's right or wrong, it's the way I do it. Unless I have to use my baby finger for something else, or I have to bar across three strings, I can't bar across three strings like this with my baby finger. So I will use this finger in those circumstances. But for the most part, if I'm just playing 2 strings, if I'm going to play three strings, I can do that, right? So play with my baby finger and this finger. But if I'm going across more than three, I just bar it that way. But if it's just 2 strings, a lot of times I'll just use my baby finger and this finger. Okay. Now, in this song, it works to my advantage because the way the riff goes, we play it this way, and then they add the string above it. So I can use this finger, which is free for this, to play that string above. So there you go. Right? So. The verse. So the verses he's singing, and the guitar comes in and starts playing that. So that little lick, then the verse. Then it goes into the pre-chorus, which jumps right into the chorus. The pre-chorus is kind of neat. It's a feel change. So it's still playing on the same beat, but the feel of the what the guitar is playing is different. I feel like the guitar player is pushing the beat. So he's coming in a little bit sooner than the beat. So music. That's the pre-chorus, but he comes from here. When he jumps from here, like to me, like I would normally play, but he comes in just a little sooner. So I don't know if you can hear the difference or you feel it, but listen to, well, it's up to you, you don't have to. If you listen to the song, it feels like he's pushing the beat a little bit. And then from that's the pre-chorus, then it goes into the chorus, which is really, really simple, three chords, and is just very staccato play. Right, that's the chorus. At the end of the chorus, he does, right, and then it goes back into riff. I hit a harmonic in there. Harmonic picking is when you take, if you hold your close to your fingers, this top end here, when you play it, if you rub your thumb against the string as you play it. Different harmonics, and there's different spots, just like there's harmonics here on the there's spots for harmonics on the neck, there are spots for harmonics up here as well. So if you hit those right spots on the string with just slightly rubbing your thumb when you play it, you'll get that harmonic. And they do that in there on that riff. I'm not sure if he does it every time, but anyway, harmonic picking. So that little riff, then it goes back into the verses and then into the chorus. Then there's a little bit of a break in there. There's a bridge, and it's a guitar bridge, which is kind of cool. I don't have it 100% down in the song, but basically he's going. But that's kind of what he's doing in there. So he's just muzzle picking. And then he slowly opens it up to the full. Second time around he walks around a little bit. I don't have it down, but from there, after it goes, it does that twice, and then he's doing some singing in there with nothing. Then it goes back into the pre-chorus, and the chorus is done. So that's it. That's kind of the breakdown of the song. There's nothing more to it. The other guitar player, he's playing a couple little things in the chorus. The other guitar guitar player is playing here on the 5th fret. He's just up here on the second last string on the 5th fret. And he's just he's playing this 5th... throws the odd in there. He's playing that through the second half of the song. Whenever it goes to the chorus, he's doing that. Even in the verses, when they're playing the verses, he's sitting on this. He's just playing that. So literally, he's playing on a single string for a bunch of the song. He does this little thing up in here. Does that a few times in the verses as well. And I'll try and throw a couple of those in there, but I can't bounce around too much from the two guitars. It's a little harder to make everything work. So anyway, there we go. So Pour Some Sugar on Me by Def Leppard. That's my little overview. And now we go. Def Leppard, pour some sugar on me. Who we got here? Hey, Giovanni. So yeah, that's it. Pretty simple overall. A couple little things in there, and like I said, I didn't really have that little break in the middle of the song 100% down. You know, trying to do it in less than an hour, and I'm trying to stay true to that. So, you know, if I don't have it 100%, I go with it the way it is. So, yeah. But a fun song to play. So, today's Wednesday, so tomorrow I'll be back. And Friday, I'm going to do something special on Friday, because Friday I was supposed to be playing a show with NTTX, but it's not happening. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play one of the NTTX songs, and I'm going to play the guitar along with it, because the recorded music doesn't have any guitars in it. So for the live show, all the guitar work that I do in the song is for the live show. The recorded, it's not the same as the recordings. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of the recorded songs and I'm going to play my guitar stuff over the recorded song. So I'm going to do that on Friday for fun, just because we were supposed to play a show on Friday and we're not. So I'm going to do a little NTTX preview for Friday. So if you've never seen us live, this is what it'll be, kind of what I do when I'm playing with the band. And if you like it, maybe down the road, next time we are playing shows and people are coming out to see bands again, maybe you want to come out and check us out. Okay, so there we go. Song for the day, Def Leppard, Pour Some Sugar on Me. Simple song, lots of fun, some really cool guitar licks in there. I love that type of stuff. And, you know, Def Leppard's known for that. Fun band. So, yeah, there we go. That's my song for today. I will be back tomorrow. I got a little late start today, but, yeah, you know, I was working a little bit late. So, yeah, tomorrow I don't know what song I'm going to do, but I will be back hopefully a little bit earlier. So we will see you then if you tune in. Later.